मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिस नविदा शेख फ्रॉम बृहन मुंबई महानगर पालिका MCGM वर्चुअल क्लास. आई वेलकम ऑल माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स टू अनदर एन इंटरेस्टिंग सेशन. इन टुडे सेशन वी विल बी लर्निंग समथिंग न्यू एंड इंटरेस्टिंग फ्रॉम अ साइंस टेक्स्ट बुक. सो लेट्स गेट एंड ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स इन योर प्रीवियस स्टैंडर्ड्स. सो आई थिंक दैट माय स्टूडेंट्स नो अ बेसिक concept about what is gravitation and what is gravitational force. Okay, and even if you do not remember, don't worry, we'll be learning together and we'll be understanding gravitation in a much better way, and we'll be learning through presentation, and I'll be explaining you all this. You have to be very particular about listening to me carefully because you cannot see me right now. Okay, so you have to listen to what I'm saying and keep going. If you think that you are not able to understand, you can go back and listen to it again and try to recollect what I have said. Okay, first thing that I'll be doing is we'll be learning about what is gravitation, circular motion and centripetal force, Kepler's law, Newton's universal law of gravitation, acceleration due to gravitational force of the earth, free fall and escape velocity. These are the things that are mentioned in our textbook that we are supposed to learn in this chapter. Okay, so the very first thing that we, what is the meaning of this word gravitation? Gravitation, the word itself, I'm not explaining you all the meaning of gravitational force. First we learn the matlab, the meaning of gravitation. Gravitation means movement or tendency to move towards something. Okay, so moving towards or attraction towards something is called as gravitation. Anything that attracts itself towards the other object, that could be because of a force. Okay, now this meaning I hope is clear. Very simple words, moving towards something or attracting towards something, that is gravitation. Now, what is gravitational force? Gravitational force is the gravitation, the force that attracts two objects. Suppose if I have two objects which have mass, we call that gravitational force if they attract each other. If by trying to pull each other together, okay, they never push away things. Now, with a very simple on the screen, this girl is trying to throw a ball. Okay, now whenever she throws a ball, even if she throws it upwards, now in this picture she is throwing it downwards, so it is going down in a proper vertical line. It doesn't go horizontally, it doesn't go in a particular angle, it falls in a proper vertical line. Now this line that it is going, this is because there is a particular force which is helping it to go directly down in this direction. Okay, now here, this your picture, it shows that we all are standing on a planet but nobody is falling. Okay, we know that earth is spherical in shape, and when we are walking around, we have vehicles, we have plants, animals, so many things are there on our planet, but nothing falls down. Why? Because there is a force which is exerted from our earth. Earth has this force naturally present which helps to attract the things which are there towards it. Okay, so this gravitational force, now I think it is clear to all of you, the force which pulls the object towards itself, that force here is called as gravitational force. Okay, samajh mein aa gayi baat? New ahead. If the concept of gravitation and gravitational force is clear to you, then the things which are going to come now will be much clearer to you. Now first you need to understand the difference between gravity and gravitation. Okay, gravity is a different word and gravitation is different. So here you can see gravitation means there are two objects and there is a force between that, and they are trying to come towards each other, attraction. Okay, gravitation is the force of attraction acting between any two bodies of the universe. Okay, whereas gravity is something else. Gravity is, there is present in the earth, which is present naturally, Earth's gravitational pull. So gravity is the Earth's gravitational pull on any body lying on or near the surface of the Earth. Now, lying on or near the surface of the Earth, this line you need to remember, because now when we go ahead, lying on the surface, right now we were learning up till now, hum log ne sirf ye padhe hai, ki if a body is on the surface of the Earth, it gets attracted towards it. Now we'll be learning about things which are above the Earth's surface as well. Okay, so let's here in this picture again I'm showing you all what is the meaning of gravitational force. Okay, gravitational force is attracting this ball towards itself. It is bouncing, it is going up, okay, but because of the Earth's gravitational force, it bounces back to the surface of the Earth. It comes back to the ground. All right, and now why it is going up again? Because it has force in it. Hum log ne pad chuke hain about various types of force. I will not be going in detail over there because we'll be emphasizing more on gravitation today. Okay, so this is because of the Earth's gravitation. There is no gravitation force. Now in the space outside our Earth gravitational force, there is no gravitational force present, okay, which can attract us towards itself. So in space, the astronauts which go, they need to have a proper equipment which helps them to connect to the entire space shuttle, okay, and if it is not present, they will flow around. Here also in this picture I'm showing all the inner image of a space shuttle where the astronauts here are moving around. They do not have gravitational force, so they are floating in the air. Okay, here you can see how they are floating. They are not walking properly like us, so there is no gravitational force and hence they are floating like this, and that is important. Okay, and we do not float like this because we already have Earth's gravitational force which is helping us to stay on the ground and walk easily. All right, was the person who thought about this gravitation. Now the phenomena of gravitation was discovered by Sir Isaac Newton. As the story goes, he discovered the force by seeing an apple fall from a tree on the ground. Okay, he wondered why all the apples are falling vertically downwards and not at an angle or any vertical. After much thought, he came to the conclusion that the Earth must be attracting the apple towards itself, and this attractive force must be directed towards the center of the Earth. Okay, so with this statement, I hope things are getting clear to you because we've already learned about gravitation. So when Sir Isaac Newton was sitting beneath a tree, apple tree, the apples were falling just below it. Okay, it wasn't flying away, or it wasn't falling at a particular angle, it was just going vertically downwards. Now he was thinking about it, that why is it happening like that? So he came up with a conclusion that there is a particular force which is present in the Earth's surface, okay, in Earth itself. This Earth is attracting all the objects towards its center. Okay, so this center is attracting things towards itself, and that is the reason whenever anything falls, it falls straight vertically downwards. Okay, so the direction from the apple on the tree to the center of the Earth is the vertical direction at the position of the apple, and thus the apple falls vertically downwards. I hope things are okay. Let's move ahead and see something interesting. Now with this example that he had in mind, whatever he saw, Sir Isaac Newton, whatever he observed beneath the tree, he came up with a concept of the gravitational force and the gravitational force between the Earth and the Moon. He was wondering, same way as the Earth is trying to attract the apple, falling apple towards its center, same way even the Moon is going round and round. It doesn't go away or it doesn't travel in a straight line. It always moves in a elliptical orbit. Okay, so he thought that the force on an apple on the tree is towards the center of the Earth, right? That is along the perpendicular from the position of the apple to the surface of the Earth. Newton thought that if the force of gravitation acts on apples on the tree at different heights from the surface of the earth. Now see, apples are not only in one particular height, they are arranged in a very different manner on a tree. Some are above, some are below. Okay, so all the apples, they fall in a particular direction only, right? Even if it is on the top, it will fall vertically downwards. Even if it is in the lower region of the tree, it will fall vertically downwards. So at different heights also, the gravitational force was acting, right? So that way he thought that even objects which are much further away from the earth, there must be also, they must be also attracted towards the earth because of the gravitational force. So he thought that even moon that is moving around the surface of the earth, sorry, not on the surface, that is moving around the earth, it is also moving only around the earth, right? It is not going away and it is not going to a particular other solar, what do you say, it doesn't go away from its particular orbit that it is revolving, and that is because of the gravitational force on the moon. Next, now the gravitational force has different effect on different planets depending upon the gravity of a particular planet or an object. Now Earth has much more gravitational force as compared to Moon. Now we have learned that, we have seen also that people have traveled onto the surface of the Moon as well. So when they went to the Moon, they could not move properly like we could move on the Earth. They were actually floating. They used to just hop and they used to go above the surface of the Earth in a much within few seconds. Okay, so that was because the moon's gravity was very less, and this helps us to understand that our weight differs on the different planets also. Okay, like Earth, if a person is weighing 200 pounds, like 90 kgs, he will be weighing 15 kilograms on Moon. So it is very interesting, right? The same person weighs different. Why? Because the Earth's gravitation force is acting upon our body. They are helping us to hold it towards the center, and that is the reason the weight appears to be more over here and the weight appears to be less on the moon's surface. Okay, so this thing is clear. Let's kind of learn something more about our great scientist that I was talking about, Sir Isaac Newton. Now, Sir Isaac Newton has contributed a lot in the field of mathematics, physics, when we learn about sound, light, calculus. This all is a contribution from Sir Isaac Newton. Okay, so he was one of the greatest scientists of recent times. He was born in England. He gave his laws of motion, equations of motions, and theory of gravity in his book Principia. Okay, before this book was written, Kepler, this he was another scientist, had given three laws describing planetary motion. Planetary motion means the planets which we have in our solar system, the movement of them. Okay, so however, the reason why planets move in the way described by Kepler's law was not known. Kepler knew that something is happening. He made a note of it. He gave out certain laws, but he did not know the reason behind it. So Newton, with the help of Kepler's law, he came up with the theory of gravity. Mathematically, he derived Kepler's law. He proved that he was right. Okay. So here, this experiment helps us understand that there is a particular force, right? Hamara haath jo ghoom raha hai, wo ek force apply kar raha hai on the stone in order to keep it moving in a circular ring. The force which is acting, which you perform on the object moving along the circle, and it is directed towards the center of the circle, this is called the centripetal force. Okay, the centripetal force, the centripetal word means center seeking, means it will be seeking center and it will be trying to move in that circular motion only. Okay, the object tries to go towards the center of the circle because of this force, and this force which is which is helping to move the stone is called as the centripetal force. Occurs, you can see it in various places. Here also, here in this picture, you can see the moon is moving around the earth in a circular position, in the circular motion. Now this is because the earth is exerting a particular force onto the moon that is helping the moon to move in this particular direction only. It is not, the moon is not moving in a straight line, it is not going away from it. Okay, it has a particular orbit which it is moving continuously in that particular direction only. Same way, our sun itself also has this force in it, gravitational force, which is helping the planets, and not only Earth but all the planets in its proper place, and which is helping it, okay, and stay in a particular position only and not roam around anywhere in the solar system. Now here this picture is very interesting, and you all can see this clearly also, how along with the moon, see, we have learned example for moon, but along with moon, I hope it is clear to you all that even the other planets in the solar system are also moving in a particular direction. And why is it? Because of the gravitational force which is there present in the sun. Okay, and this centripetal force is helping them to move in a particular circular orbit. I hope this much is clear to my students. We will stop here for today, and we'll be continuing with the later part of the chapter in the next coming period. I hope you have enjoyed learning this, because it is related to our planet and our locality, that we do everything, these things that we perform everyday activities are very much related to the chapter that we are learning today. So please try and learn, go home and revise this. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you. If you liked the session, please do not forget to subscribe to our channel so that you can share and view the videos that we had today for you. And please do not forget to hit the bell icon so that you remain updated with all the latest videos that we'll be making for our dear students. This session was quite useful to you. In the next coming period, we'll learn something new and interesting. Till then, thank you.